Hey guys, Thunderhound369 here, and today we're going to be taking a look at Transformers Energon Ironhide. Now, I gotta say, I wasn't never too thrilled with anything from the Unicron trilogy, especially Energon, but I mean, there were a few hit and miss items. And Ironhide here, I never really did pick up when he first came out. Never really did interest me. But I found him a few days ago, maybe a couple weeks ago, at a local thrift store that recently opened up around here. Because that's something we don't have a whole lot of around here, are thrift stores. So I found him at a thrift store for, I think, $2. I mean, he's in fairly good condition. Looks like I think there's a piece missing from here, but I'm not too concerned with trying to track that down. Because like I said, I wasn't really too thrilled about wanting to pick this guy up back then, but I figured what the heck, I found him at a thrift store for a couple dollars, I'd pick him up. So I'll give you a little bit of BG on his tech specs here. It says, if trouble doesn't find me, I'll find it. Ironhide is a young and reckless recruit. He is a good fighter, but lacks the discipline and experience of his Autobot elders. Able to power links with Jetfire, Ironhide can crunch Decepticon metal with the best of them. His powerful laser cannons is a feared weapon by his enemies. With a little guidance, he is sure to become a seasoned warrior. Now, like I said, you know, I wasn't really too thrilled with the Energon series, especially with this guy here on the show. I found him, his character on the series, Ironhide's character, was a little bit on the annoying side. I didn't really like that character for it being called Ironhide anyway. But as far as the overall figure, I mean, the figure is not that bad, except for just this big chunk right here on the truck, you know. I think this is an unnecessary addition, but what do we get? We can't throw our ideas out there. I mean, we throw our ideas out there, they just mess them up anyway. But anyway, like I said, the character Ironhide in the Energon series was, like I said, annoying at times. I didn't really like the character that well. But again, the figure's not that bad. I mean, it's a little, as far as the vehicle itself, it's kind of a little on the play school kind of side. It looks a little kiddified, you can tell. The only real thing that I don't like is, just like I said, this overall block right here. I think they could have done away with this and put his head somewhere else to hide it completely. But anyway, we got this blue paint job with some white, black tires with silver wheels. I mean, I do like the idea. You got the open cockpit, you can see in there to, you can see the driver's side and passenger side seats in there. It's supposed to resemble some kind of a push bar or brush guard or whatever they call those. There's spark crystal or Autobot spark crystal here. Got the power link symbol here. I think there's, no, I thought there was one on the other side, but it's not. What I can't understand is we got a gold painted window over here. You come around here to the same window on the opposite side, it's painted blue with the super links symbol. that's just too inconsistent for me as well. And then we got the gold, we got the painted window, the window windshield. I mean, this big block up here on top, I do wish they could have done something with the head if they was going to go that route anyway. I think this is, this thing makes noises. Like I said, I hadn't owned it up until a few weeks ago. So I think it's electronic. Looks like a battery compartment there, so I haven't really tried that out. It's supposed to have a missile, a little rocket that goes in here, but don't have that. So anyway, we'll go ahead and transform him. Like I said, I didn't have instructions, so don't really need them anyway. Open all this up in the front. Pop these out. There's his legs. Split them apart. As far as his arms, just bring them around to the front. I'm not getting into his super link deal. I'm not going to go that route. I'll have to adjust the camera a little bit. Pardon me. Anyway, here we have Ironhide in his robot mode. As you can see, he's a bit beefy in this mode, which I don't mind the robot mode. The robot mode looks pretty good. I really do like it. It's got a nice little paint job on it with all the blue and the red and the tan or whatever that color is right there, that poop brown, I guess. That's what I'm calling it, is poop brown. I mean, there's hardly no kibble on this guy at all. I mean, the only kibble you got are the side panels that open up to make these shoulder wings. Like I said, you know, you can... There's another transformation for this guy. He can combine with Jetfire. Well, he can combine with a couple others from this line as well. But Jetfire is pretty much the one he combines with in the show. Articulation. His overall his head doesn't move itself, but you can get a little bit. The whole assembly rotates full 360. The shoulders, due to the fact that he's got these shoulder wings, will not go full 360. Will come out to the side. No upper bicep, but he can rotate at the elbow due to the ball joint as well as bend. No fist articulation. I mean, it's just a straight molded plastic fist. No, he does have some articulation. Well, you can get him to do this, but other than that, I wouldn't really count that as ab articulation or anything. Nice little Autobot logo there on his chest. Look at his head sculpt, which is fairly decent. And he come it through here and his waist, his legs will go back to there, out to the front. All nice little clickety clickety ratchet joints. Will come out to the side. Bends at the knee to there. As well as he can rotate full 360 at the knee. And I guess you could say he does have toe articulation. But that's mostly due to the bumper transformation. So there we have Energon Ironhide. And now, like I said, I didn't pick this guy up right off the bat. You know, when they first came out with the Energon series, I usually don't grab things right off the bat. I usually kind of pick and choose. You might say I'm a cherry picker, but I mean, if it's got the Transformer name on it, I will buy it at some point. But I'm not going to grab everything right off the bat. I'll either wait for it to go on clearance or, you know, like I said, flea market or something like that. And I found this guy at a thrift store. But, to be honest with you, I'm trying to think of whether I want to recommend picking this guy up or not. If you don't have him, and you want to add him to your collection, you know, try to find him cheap. Trying to find him as cheap as you possibly can. You know, at a thrift store or a flea market or a garage sale. I mean, to be honest with you, I wouldn't hit eBay and pay an outrageous price for him. I mean, I'd pay as cheap as I could pay if I was anybody going to pick this guy up. Pay as cheap as you can. Because to be honest with you, if it hadn't have been for the thrift store, finding him at a thrift store, I wouldn't have picked him up. He would have never been in my collection. Because I avoided him this long. Because, quite frankly, the vehicle, it's not a bad-looking vehicle until you look at all this crap right here on top of it. And then it just looks like crap. The robot mode, I'm not complaining too much about. The articulation, the arms not being able to go full 360, that doesn't bother me. These big shoulder wings sticking out doesn't bother me that well. But, you know, the Superlink deal, I'm not too fond of on some of these Energon guys. But as far as Ironhide here, like I said, pick him up as cheap as you possibly can. That's all I can say. If you've already got him, you know, hey, great. But if you don't have him, find him for as cheap as you can possibly find him. Because, to be honest with you, I never was a big fan of the Energon series. And the character for Ironhide in that series got on my nerves so bad that I just couldn't bring myself to pick him up when he first came out. So, like I said, and there is supposedly some kind of a repaint for this guy. I think in green, but it doesn't help none. It's just a straight green repaint. So, guys, I'm Thunderhound369. This has been my look at Transformers Energon Ironhide. And like I said, pick him up, but pick him up as cheaply as you possibly can. Don't spend a whole lot on him. Don't strain yourselves looking for him. And again, I want to say, I'm Thunderhound369. Thanks for watching the video. I hope everybody's enjoyed it. Until next time, guys, I'm out of here. See y'all.